2020, why people do what they are told. I've spoken with a lot of people since the nightmare of 2020 began and have heard a variety of common themes. How that everything is a hoax, we're all doomed, Jesus will save us, Trump will save us, maybe even that we don't deserve to be saved. One of the themes that seems to get hidden in all the noise and chaos is why so many people are going along with the insanity without any resistance at all. You know who I'm talking about. The sheep, the zombies, the drones, the mouth-breathing troglodytes, whatever you want to call them. They are everywhere, and despite how much pressure and heat are turned up on this civilization, they keep adjusting their daily lives and lurching forward, or in this case, backward. Yes, it's frustrating to watch. How is it that your friends, family members, and coworkers can't see the giant red flashing lights right in front of their face? How is it that they are comfortable turning on their own? How is it that they are actually helping to tear down their own civilization without wringing their hands and looking to the heavens for inspiration and guidance? The short and brutal answer is that it's built into us. It's not as bad as you think, but then again, it's also much worse. Let's get the good news out of the way first. It is very hard to get a person to actually kill another person. Even as late as World War II, only 20% of the armed soldiers had the nerve to actually pull the trigger and attempt to kill another human being. Most of us have no stomach for it. That, however, is where the mercy ends. Take away the direct hand-on-hand violence, and everything is back on the table. Anyone who has taken a psychology course in college may remember a vague description of an experiment where people were using electric shocks on each other. Officially, it's called the Milgram experiment, and it may not seem like much at first glance, but I think it has become very relevant in 2020. The experiment was first conducted at Yale University some 60 years ago, and it revolves around the obedience to authority. It was initially designed as a way to explain the psychology of genocide. In other words, were the Nazis an unusually cruel group, or does this apply to everyone under the right circumstances? The experiment was simple and ingenious in its design. You sign up for a run-of-the-mill psychology experiment in which you will get paid regardless of the outcome. You meet a supervisor and one other person just like yourself. At least, that's what they want you to think. There is no randomness in this little play. Both the supervisor and your fellow lab rat are in on the game. The supervisor draws out of a hat on who is going to ask the questions and who is going to answer them. Your name is picked to ask questions. It was, of course, predetermined. Your teammate goes into another room and is hooked up to a series of electrodes. You can't see him, only hear his voice through an intercom system. You ask your teammate a series of matching questions. If the answer was incorrect, you would administer a shock to the other person with a voltage increasing in 15-volt increments for each wrong answer. The volts ranged from 15 to 450. The shock generator included verbal markings that vary from slight shock to danger, severe shock. The subjects believed that for each wrong answer, the person was receiving actual shocks. In reality, there were no shocks. After the person went to another room, they set up a tape recorder integrated with the electroshock generator, which played pre-recorded sounds for each shock level. As the voltage of the fake shocks increased, the person began making audible protests, such as banging repeatedly on the wall that separated him from you. In every condition, the person makes or says a predetermined sound or word. When the highest voltages were reached, the subject fell silent. If at any time you indicated a desire to halt the experiment, the supervisor was instructed to give specific verbal prods. The prods were in this order: please continue, or please go on. The experiment requires that you continue. It is absolutely essential that you continue. You have no other choice. You must go on. The professors predicted that only 1 to 3% of all subjects would continue and keep upping the voltage until their partner passed out and died. What really happened, though, showed our true nature. During the first set of experiments, 65%, 26 out of 40, subjects pushed the button and killed their teammate with the final massive 450-volt shock. And all subjects made it to at least 300 volts. The professor's conclusion was easy to make, and haunting. The extreme willingness of adults to go to almost any lengths on the command of an authority constitutes the chief finding of the study, and the fact most urgently demanding explanation. Ordinary people, simply doing their jobs, and without any particular hostility on their part, can become agents in a terrible destructive process. Moreover, even when the destructive effects of their work become patently clear, and they are asked to carry out actions incompatible with fundamental standards of morality, relatively few people have the mental resources needed to resist authority. And as the experiment was refined, it got worse. If you conducted the experiment when there was another actor already there shocking another person, then the power of conformity set in, and the chance of you killing the person in the next room goes up over 90%. This experiment has been repeated many times over the years in different states and countries, and the results are what you might expect. People do as they are told. They bend and break their own personal values if someone in authority asks them to. They follow orders, even if it causes the destruction of the world around them. You, however, are different. If you are listening to this, then you understand right and wrong. Authority has its place, but it can only go so far before you stand your ground. It helps me sleep to know that there are at least a few of you out there in the world, carving small caves of sanity out of the madness. Don't forget, however, that when you walk the streets, most of the people around you are not you. They listen to the media and do whatever it says, no matter how illogical. Remember that to most, the media is now the ultimate authority. To quote a favorite movie of mine, we believe the world that is presented to us. And currently, that world is being shaped by the faces on our phones. Remember that and stand strong, because the next big experiment is right around the corner.